That's it.
Well, yeah, I know how to do it.
Thank you.
It's not level. Yeah. Yeah, there we go.
49.
Fuzzy on you.
You know, like, it's not, like, it goes phases, like, blurs and then de-blurs.
That happened to me a couple times since.
Keeps happening. Alright, I put on auto for it. Let's just put it back in.
Thank you.
Rosie. My name is Rosie.
My name is Hartsy.
Here to go. Fondy's up 42-26. We got Drake here in the line. Benny.
when you would hear in arms waiting for tonight. Oh, I've dreamed of love for so long, waiting for tonight. Oh, tonight, when you would be here in my arms waiting for tonight. Oh, tonight, I've dreamed of this love for so long, waiting for tonight. Oh, when you would be here in my arms waiting for tonight. Oh, tonight, I've dreamed of this love for so long, waiting for tonight. Oh.
K107 FM is KFIZ FM, Fond du Lac, Oshkosh, and Appleton.
The Weekly Top 5 on the radio.
From Hollywood, I'm Jeff Davis. For the next hour, we're on the radio jamming the best music from your favorite stars. We also count down the top 5 songs in the land. We start with number 5. This week, it's Brian McKnight's Back at One. When Brian records an album, he likes to play
more. He'll leave it in the back for Graber, wrong side. Look, pick can't get it. This Cardinals rep off it. Graber right to the hole, traveling before he gets there.
Good defense there by Travis Diener, doing a good job moving his feet, causing the turnover.
So just underway here, no score in the opening quarter of play. The clock is stopped. It hasn't run now since the open bin bottom of the ball. Stuck at 7:38. Now they get it going. Glider to the hoop by Diener is good. Drake Diener.
I think they're really going to look to exploit that matchup there with Vandenberg on Drake.
You like that matchup?
Drake's got a lot more quickness in him. Look for him to take him off the dribble this game.
Size about the same, but it is a quickness factor. We've got, what was that, away from the basketball?
Moving pick, I believe, is what they're going to call on 22.
No, they didn't, it's not a foul because they didn't put anything up on the board.
I think it was a 5-second call.
Okay, closely guarded?
Yep.
All right. Drake with it again. They're going to call a carry on Drake.
That's a bad call.
It was probably there, Mark, but the fact of the matter is you don't see it called very often.
That's the thing on white balance.
So it's 2-0, your Wisconsin EPS score here, just over 7:10 to go here in the first quarter of play. Graber with the basketball, bounce pass between the rings to the near side. Zwickowski back right once again, swing it back to Graber. Top of the circle between the rings. Looking down low on the post up, this is Vandenberg, and he'll lay it in.
Well, Tim Lloyd there got caught cheating, trying to get the steal. They get the inlet. Actually, they did a good job of bounce passing into him, because if they get the pass, he may have stole that.
You like that bounce pass. You talk about that a lot.
I like that bounce pass.
Trey on the way from Drake. Book it. Well, Mark, they're right back that you talked about, going back to Drake Diener, and he had the open look.
Yeah, he hasn't shot as many threes this year as I think.
I agree with you.
5-2, you DPS score, 20 to go in the opening quarter of play. Pull up, partially blocked there by Fond du Lac. I think Thomas got a piece of that, and here come the Cardinals. Dallas Diener across the timeline to Drake. Now Travis, left side sidewalk. He'll reload it, bring it back out, hole high. Now between the rings, and Drake again, way above the arc. Lloyd popping out above the key. Thomas will take the long tray on the way. Off the rim, won't go, followed by Timmy Lloyd. No box out.
Timmy Lloyd has been a big key with this team on rebounds there. Nobody boxed him out, and he gets the easy lay-in.
Cardinals up 7-2, 5:45 to go in the first quarter of play. Looking back door, trying to get it down low to Vandenberg. Tipped away, the Cardinals with it. Drake over to Travis. He hasn't taken the shot yet. Now it's on the way off the front of the hoop. No good. And pulled down by Zwickowski for the Papermakers.
Who's up?
So they'll get it through offense. Wachowski with it, left side. And that's his first foul of the basketball. Go on Timmy Lloyd.
Vandenberg doing a good job of boxing out when he's down low. Look, Tim Lloyd's going to have to be careful because they're not going to let him play too rough.
First game was called, for those that were here, it was called very tight all the way through. By the way, Fond du Lac Cardinals with, I think it was about a 7-point win, JV basketball. Offensive foul this time. He's going to go on Vandenberg.
That's the that's the fourth turnover already for Kimberly, so Fond du Lac's really cranking up on defense today.
See the score, 56-45. I guess they put a couple, I did walk out of here late and get a soda before the game, so they got a couple late points apparently.
Yeah.
Fond 5:10 to go in this first quarter. As we said, John Myron felt was very key. Fondulac will pull up, Drake Deet, or Jeff Travis, easy for me to say, from about 12 feet.
Well, what we saw in the Oshkosh West game is Travis Diener is very important to this team, and we need him to get hot right away in this game if the Cardinals want to pull out a victory.
Certainly the fact that Travis was in Cardinals rep off it, Graber right to the before he gets.
Good defense there by Travis Diener, doing a good job moving his feet, causing the turnover.
So just underway here, no score on the opening quarter of play. The clock is stopped and hasn't run now since they opened out of the ball. Stuck at 7:38, now they get it going. Glider to the hoop by Diener is good, Drake Diener.
I think they're really going to look to exploit that matchup there with Vandenberg on Drake.
You like that matchup?
Drake's got a lot more quickness in him. Look for him to take him off the dribble this game.
Size about the same, but it is a quickness factor. We've got, what was that, away from the basketball?
Moving pick, I believe, is what they're going to call on 22.
No, it's not a foul because they didn't put anything up on the board.
I think it was a 5-second call.
Okay, closely guarded?
Yep.
All right. Drake with it again. They're going to call a carry on Drake.
That's a bad call.
It was probably their mark, but the fact of the matter is you don't see it called very often.
That's right. On white balance.
So it's 2-0, your Wisconsin EPS score here, just over 7:10 to go here in the first quarter of play. Graber with the basketball, bounce pass between the rings to the near side. Swakowski back right once again, swing it back to Graber.
The song that introduced the world.
Up, this is Vandenberg.
Well, Tim, trying to get the steal, they get the inlet. Actually, they did a good job of bounce passing into him because if they get the pass, he may have stole that.
You like that bounce pass. You talk about that a lot.
I like that bounce pass.
Trey on the way from Drake. Book it. Oh, Mark, they're right back that you talked about, going back to Drake Diener, and he had the open look.
Yeah, he hasn't shot as many threes this year as I thought he would. I think Drake's got to take his game on the perimeter a little bit more than what he has been.
I agree with you.
5-2, your Wisconsin EPS score, 6:20 to go in the opening quarter of play. Pull up, partially blocked there by Fondulac. I think Thomas got a piece of that, and here come the Cardinals. Dallas Diener across the timeline to Drake. Now Travis, left side sidewalk. He'll reload it, bring it back out, whole high. Now between the rings, and Drake again, way above the arc. Lloyd popping out above the key. Thomas will take the long tray on the way, off the rim, won't go, followed by Timmy Lloyd. No box out.
Timmy Lloyd has been a big key with this team on rebounds there. Nobody boxed him out, and he gets the easy lay-in.
Cardinals up 7-2, 5:45 to go in the first quarter of play. Looking back door, trying to get it down low to Vandenberg, tipped away, the Cardinals with it. Drake over to Travis. He hasn't taken the shot yet. Now it's on the way off the front of the hoop, no good. And pulled down by Swakowski for the Papermakers.
Who's up?
So they'll get it to their offense. Swakowski with it, left side. And a pushing foul on Fondulac. I think they'll get Lloyd. That's what it is. First foul of the basketball game. Well, good. Go on Timmy Lloyd.
Vandenberg doing a good job of boxing out when he's down low. Look, Tim Lloyd's going to have to be careful because they're not going to let him play too rough.
First game was called, for those that were here, it was called very tight all the way through. By the way, Fondulac Cardinals with, I believe it was about a 7-point win. JV basketball. Offensive foul this time is going to go on Vandenberg.
That's the the fourth turnover already for Kimberly, so Fondulac's really cranking up on defense today.
See the score, 56-45. I guess they put a couple, I did walk out of here late and get a soda before the game, so they got a couple late points apparently.
Yeah.
Five, 10 to go in this first quarter. As we said, John Myron felt was very key. Fondulac will pull up, Drake Deet, or Jeff Travis, easy for me to say, from about 12 feet.
Well, what we saw in the Oshkosh West game is Travis Diener is very important to this team, and we need him to get hot right away in this game if the Cardinals want to pull out a victory.
Certainly the fact that Travis was in foul trouble a lot of that game prohibited him from getting into his game.
Yeah, I happened to go up to the game on Tuesday night, and I think Travis really made a statement. He really bounced back, and I think he had like 25 points, so.
Quick timeout's going to be taken. It's a full. It's not a quick. Full timeouts taken by the Papermakers. 4:50 to go in the first quarter of play. Wisconsin EPS score, Fond du Lac 9, Kimberly 2.
Baker's string cheese?
Yes, here. Save some for your brother's lunch.
Well, I'm here. Mike, you ready to take it back? Come back to Mike.
Right back here at the Redbird Arena, 4:50 to go in the first quarter play, 9-2. The Wisconsin EPS score, we said the Fond du Lac got off this burly lead that John Myron had mentioned maybe to me before the game. He thought it was a big key that he could not let Fond du Lac get out early in this basketball game, and thus far they have.
Well, the Cardinals already have 7 shot attempts. They've made 5 of them compared to just 2 attempts for Kimberly.
Fond du Lac's always been known to get out of the gates and, you know, take teams, you know, out of it right away, which is a great thing to have.
Especially on your home court.
Yep.
Travis draws the contact as he takes it to the hole. Foul should go on Rinke. That's what it is, his first personal. Travis will go to the line to shoot a pair. First is good, 1 to follow. 1-2 here from the Redbird Arena.
I think they screwed up in that call. It should have been on 3, Graber, instead of 33, Reinke.
Okay, and you're exactly right. They have changed it. It will go on Graber. And a pair by Travis, as I was mentioning, 1-2 today here. As a little bit later this evening, we'll have gals basketball, Fond du Lac Lady Cardinals taking on the Nina Rockets from the Redbird Arena. 8 o'clock tip-off, we'll have that one for you at 10 o'clock later this evening. Trey is off the rim. Here come the Cardinals on the push. 2-on-1 bust out. Drake will pull it up now. It's going to take it to the hoop with the glide to give him an opening. Overlays and a foul on Gallisteiner, his first. Well, they had Drake on the baseline double up, and then both defenders kind of backed off a little bit and gave him an opening right to the basket. Got a pretty good look.
There you saw a lot of patience by Drake. You see a lot of players that once they're double teamed, they try to make the pass right away, and that's when a lot of turnovers are caused. There he made the ball fake. Both players actually left him, and he did get a decent look at the basket.
Now that's called experience. And living with a coach, huh? Ball bang free. Turn around. Put back won't go. Follow up. Overlaid, but a foul on Fond du Lac as Rinke got the offensive board and is fouled. Drake Diener picks up his first.
Yeah, they're going to have to get a body on that Rinke 33. He was an all-conference player last year. He's just an animal in the paint, so they got to find a body and get it on him. Box him out of there.
Rinke is listed at 6'2". Looks bigger than that. But he's got, as you said, a good body on him, and certainly will move bodies around. Looks like a lineman. Misses a pair from the line, and Foster with the board. Travis will take the 17-footer, hit the front of the rim, and pulled down by Graber for the Papermakers, and he'll bring it across the timeline.
Travis coming just a little short on his shots. You think he's going a little too quick.
Three-pointer turnaround won't go on a post-up, and Carter's away with it. Cheating on the break, got Thomas out front. But the defense transitions very quickly, and Ben Thomas has, per normal, a good, wise decision there rather than going 1-on-3. Travis with it off to Foster, left side sidewalk. Bring it back up, reload, off the arc. Looking now, traveling violation on Gallisteiner. Turnover Fond du Lac, and up off the pines for Kimberly is Ryan Hermes, along with Doug Van de Kuyk.
There we see a little of that patience call where Dallas just wanted that shot real quickly. Defender came over and caused the turnover.
3:15 to go in the first quarter of play. Fond du Lac leads it by 9 at 11-2. Graber with the basketball off the right side sidewalk. Now looking back door, gets it inside. Bank it, no good, off the front of the rim from Van Kuyk. And a foul on a retaliation. And this time I do believe they will get Rinke.
If Kimberly wants to stay in the game, they really need to make these easy bunny shots. That was an easy lay-in for Kimberly, and they missed it.
Van Kuyk, actually, I was wrong on that. Van Kuyk gets the foul, not Rinke. I'm going to say Van Kuyk got it from the bad side. Backside, I should say. So the Cardinals are bringing it across the timeline with just under three to go in the first quarter of play. The other team has scored now for a little bit. Off top of the key, Dallas to Foster. On the three-point arc, will work it right now, back left. Bump, bang, foul. Blocking foul down low. And it should be on for Fort, and that's what it is. His first personal. Cardinals inbound on the common foul underneath the old hoop. Get it out to Drake Diener, top of the circle. Foster fakes the three, now take the 18-footer, draw nothing but air. Might have forced that one a little bit. Papermakers quickly down court. Now they reload as Graber with the basketball, working between the legs. Now he's gonna come to the near side of the court. Off to the left side sidewalk. Lermis will take the long two. Tipped, kept alive. Drake Diener with the rebound for Fond du Lac. Pushing it, getting it down low. Bump, bang, no call, but it'll go back to Fond du Lac as the Travis tried to thread the needle and get it down to Dallas underneath the hoop, and it was banged out of bounds.
I think that was a good no call by the official. Really not a lot of contact there. But good court vision by Travis Diener, seeing Dave Drake, excuse me, Dallas wide open.
Jekyll in, Thomas back in for Fond du Lac. As Foster, we'll check who else left.
Dallas Diener.
Dallas is okay. Cardinals inbound, 11-2, your Wisconsin EPS score. They get it inbound to Lloyd. Tim Lloyd, the ball above his head, now reloaded out top. Thomas on the dribble, now needs a cutter. Somebody's got to come and help, ball bang free. Good hustle by Lloyd to take it back. Bodies on the floor, Lloyd with hustle, touch pass down low. Jekyll give and go to Travis. Bump, bang, no call inside. Oh, Travis was hit pretty hard and no whistle. And a traveling violation the other way. Dick Diener asking, what happened down there?
Travis really holding his left arm. He came down hard on that elbow.
Yeah, you can see him kind of flexing the fingers to get some feeling back in that arm. Dallas Diener back in. Who's coming? Yes, indeed. It is Travis that will exit. Got a little bit of a grimace on his face. Check that, 1:45 to go in the first quarter of play from the Redbird Arena. 9-2. Defense has been outstanding again. Only 2 points here with inside of a minute and a half to go in the first quarter. Dallas with it, kick it back out. Reload, skip pass, far side. Tim Lloyd on the baseline. He's cut off. Good defense from the weak side. Thomas has it blocked from behind. Taken away by Van Kuyk. Gets it out front to Hermes. And no, a foul before, that's going to be on Lloyd. No, it's going to be on, is that Dallas?
Dallas, I think.
I got that look-alike haircut. Dallas with his second personal. And Travis right back in, that's good to see.
That's as a player, when you get two fouls in the first half for Fond, like you usually sit the remainder of the half, so that's no fun for Dal.
Is it pretty much now we won't see him for the half? It will usually go that long with two?
Yeah, when he's got two,
usually keeps him off for the half. You know, he doesn't want him picking up that third foul before
and
half.
I don't argue with that tendency. I think, too, it's always your key players. You need them down the stretch.
Yep.
Well, especially the game where the Cardinals leading by 9-2.
Right.
You can afford to sit Dallas.
Trey won't go. Pulled down on the offensive board by Hermes. Well, Myron told me that they've been having a lot of trouble putting points on the board this year. That's been their weakness, and it certainly has been exploited again today as here a three ball just grazes the rim, will go out of bounds, back to Fond du Lac.
Kimberly has missed their last 9 shots. They're just 1 of 10 from the field in this first quarter.
Hit their first one of the basketball game and haven't hit one since.
And they've actually had really good looks at the basket. There was a nice look at the three and didn't even pull any rim.
Fond du Lac, first time around, held Kimberly to 26 points on their home court with a 43-26 win. So D, and Fond du Lac still is number one in the conference in D. Team defense, inside of 30 seconds to go. I think Fond du Lac is going to look for the last shot. Travis Diener holding the ball at the center of the court. Now they'll start the 5 second count. Travis has got to move it. They do. Down to eight. Cardinals will start the offense. Drake will take the 16 footer and hit it.
That's a tough shot.
Great crossover dribble by Drake to get that last open shot.
And we've come to the end of one here from the Redbird Arena. After one quarter of play, your Wisconsin EPS score, the Fond du Lac Cardinals 13 and the Kimberly Papermakers 2. Brent, Mark, and I will be right back for the second quarter right after this on your Cardinal Basketball Report.
Not all financial institutions are alike. Marine Credit Union strives to be your first choice when it comes to all your financial needs. We offer a full line of products and services, including no-fee checking accounts, time and debit cards, and a complete line of loan products. Membership is open to anyone living or working in Fond du Lac County, the City of Waupun, and select townships in Dodge County. Marine Credit Union, with 5 locations to serve you in Fond du Lac, North Fond du Lac, and Waupun. Member NCUA.
There you go. Welcome back to the Redbird Arena. Right now, Brett Krause with the first quarter stats.
Well, the Cardinals shot 5 of 13 for 38%. Kimberly just 1 of 10 for 10%. Kimberly did control the boards with 8 first quarter rebounds compared to just 6 for the Cardinals. With turnovers, got 4 for Kimberly and 3 for the Cardinals.
Well, a little discussion on the court here. Mark, I know you had the headphones off trying to hear some of this. I think what this is about is Graber did not have his shirt tucked in. They apparently warned him one time, and the referee says, no, you can't come back on the court.
Yeah, and right when he made him sit out, when the ref had his back to Trav, Trav tucked in
his
shirt.
Tucked his in, yeah. Well, that is if he was warned once, that is a correct ruling. You warn a player one time to tuck it in. A second time, he's got it out. He's got to go sit in the bench on next turn of stop the clock.
Jeez, Kimberly, they can't throw it in the ocean, I don't think.
That's a pretty bad shot. I think Dave would even hit the ocean. Then again, maybe not. Get it down low to Jekyll. Reload it, kick it out top of the circle. Travis off to the left side. Lloyd off the baseline, good from 14.
That is Tim Lloyd's favorite shot from that baseline corner. Usually he'll bring that down, no trouble.
Yeah, he's got a good touch out there from 15 feet.
Cardinals now 15-2, your Wisconsin EPS score. All Fond du Lac here in the first half of play. Fight with the basketball. First time he's been in the game to start the second quarter. Lob feed down low, trying to get it to Vandenberg. Knocked out of bounds, back to Fond du Lac.
Kimberly having trouble. They're really looking, I think, a little bit too hard to get that lob pass into Vandenberg. He's being double teamed, great team defense. What I think Kimberly needs to do is move the ball a little quicker around the perimeter and get that ball inside a little quicker.
Graber back in the basketball game. Now all tidied up, shirt tucked in. Drake Diener at the ball, kick it out, reload it to Thomas. He'll pull up, now work it to the right. Three-pointer on the way. Bingo for Travis.
It's a good kick out by Ben.
And with that, John Myron wants another timeout. 6:35 to go in the first. Cardinals lead it 18.
Before you head to the rink this season, you have to stop first at the Sports Shop 2 or the Pony Box. They both have a full line of Baller CCM and Mega Gear, and a new line of figure skates from Rydell to Lake Placid. That's the Sports Shop 2 and the Penalty Box.
And you got it back.
After the 22nd timeout, just back in time for the Papermakers inbound to basketball. Looking back door on Alley Loop, good! Well, nice job. Ricky gets the bucket. Good assist.
K Kimberly's always been known to run those specials out of the timeouts and at the end of quarters and stuff like that. So,
but only their fourth point of the basketball game. We've played nearly 10 minutes.
Hit that.
Travis from the baseline. Bango again, a long two. He seems to have found the range now. Travis leading the way for Fond du Lac with 9 points. Drake with 7 thus far. 20-4, all Fond du Lac here early in the basketball game. Off the baseline to pull up. Jay is good again, this time by Schwakowski. His first points in the basketball game. Kimberly with no one with more than 2 points. 3 players with a bucket each. Drake off to the left side to Travis Diener. Free throw line extended. Now he's going to work it back to the middle. Lloyd's got an opening to take it to the hoop, but he's cut off nicely by the defense. Good weak side job by Rinke. Thomas over to the near side. 3-pointer on the way. Counted, plus one. Give the foul to Vandenberg. Drake with the tray.
That was another great kick out by Ben. Got a little penetration. Kicked it out to Drake.
You know, as a point guard, you know, you gotta love being Ben Thomas because he's got two of the best perimeter shooters in the state. And when he can kick it out, you know they're shooting better than 40% from 3-point. You know they're gonna hit it.
Yep. Kind of feel like Sam Cassell out there when
That's
you got
right.
the big dog and Ray Allen in the wings, huh? Drake rims the free throw in. Foster back in for Fond du Lac, and leaving will be Jesse Jekyll. 5:23 to go in the first half of play. 24-6 here, Wisconsin EPS score. Been all Cardinals since the get-go. Off the right sidewalk, top of the circle. Long two on the way from Rinke. Won't go. Cardinals with the board. Here they come. Drake off the near side. Skip pass to Lloyd, top of the key. He'll back up. Now hit Foster at the free throw line extended. Good ball rotation again by the Fond du Lac Cardinals. Thomas, get it down low. Nice skip pass. Diagonal to Foster. Misses the free throw. The Jay, the strip by Drake Dieter. Now a foul on Lloyd.
Foul.
They're going to say Lloyd draped him with a weak side hand. It's a bit of a look of disgust from Timmy Lloyd. He'll pick up number 2.
That's one thing I don't like seeing. The ball's rolling on the ground. I think it should all be free play. You know, you should...
Well,
be able to go after the ball.
It's like the officials are punishing the player for good hustle.
Yeah, that's true.
That's what you're seeing.
There are these two guys jumping on the officials again. Got poor guys out there working their butts off.
We don't get fined for ripping on the officials.
Looking down to Brinke on the baseline. Cut off there by Thomas with a bit of a mismatch, but Rinke forces up over the top. Nice job by Thomas. Ball banged away, however, and picked up by Schwakowski. And what do we have? Foul. It's going to be, Thomas will pick up the foul. His first personal. Sixth team foul, 24-6. Score remains with 4:26 to go in the first half of play. Off the right side, Van Kuyk now working off to the baseline. Graber and a holding foul down low. They're going to call on Foster now.
I think that one could have went either way. Rise also used his arm to push Ben off, so I think that one could have went either way.
Foster picks up number 1. And that'll put the Cardinals over the limit to the free throw line. We'll go Rob Rise. Misses the one and only he'll get. Kimberly now 0-for-3 from the free throw line, and that certainly doesn't help at all when you're not shooting well. Drake Diener, left side free throw line extended, back and out to Foster. Look out, bad pass. Well, that kind of got through the direction of Thomas, and behind him was Travis Diener, and neither one knew which way the ball was going to go.
Well, Ben Thomas did a little ball fake there. Travis thought he was going to get it right away, so they both actually cut back, and then that's when Al Foster made the pass. Just a little bad timing there.
Yep. So off the turnover, but still an unforced turnover, which you don't like to see in any basketball game. Verfoot with it. Skip pass to the near side. Graber tries to penetrate and travels before he gets inside. Drew some contact from Foster, but the travel came first.
That was a good call.
Hey, Mark's working back on the good side of the officials again now.
Leaving me hanging.
You still the bad boy. Drake Dieter cut off at the free throw line. He's got to reload it. Now it's tripped. And followed by Hermes is Travis Dieter. Ryan Hermes up number one. 16 foul, so Nick's foul. This will be a common foul. Next time around, Fondulac will start shooting. 3-3-3 on the clock here in the first quarter, first half, I should say. 24-6 Fondulac. Penetration, fallback shot by Travis Wilkel, put back by Jesse Jekyll.
He's been stepping up the last couple days. That Nina game, he got some major minutes and played real good for him, so they need Jesse stepping it up.
Down low, picked up, put back in by Rob Royce. Little garbage buck down low.
You know, Mark, it's always important to get good quality minutes and good points from your bench because your five starters can't be there in every day.
That's true. You know, they're a little more than a month left in their season. They really got to start cranking it up right now.
One thing I think that Fondulac's, had pretty much of a reasonably strong bench, I think, over the years. One reason is their bench plays against their starters in practice every day, and that's got to make them good.
Oh, definitely.
It makes them a developed character, if nothing else, because they probably get the, what beat out of here day and day after practice.
Yeah, Fondulac always had an excellent bench.
Who got that one? Was that Jekyll again?
That was Drake.
Drake Dieter, okay.
Good two-man show there between Travis and Drake going in and out, and Drake make the good move with the right little hand hook.
Oh, nice move to the bucket as Hermes throws it kind of against the grain and gets it to go his first point of the basketball game. And after only 2 points in the first quarter, they've got eight here in the first 6 minutes of the second quarter, so can really shine to warm it up here a little bit. Travis off to Jekyll on a skip pass now. Fondulac using a skip pass seems more today than they have in recent games.
Yeah, I think that's one thing they need to do more of. If you have Drake or Trav buried in the corner, that skip pass is going to get them open every time, or open for a shot.
Travis gives a strip from him. Graber with it. He's going to try to take it coast to coast off the left hand. Overlays, followed by Hermes. Well, good hustle by Ryan Hermes to follow that one and get the easy two on the putback.
Well, you're seeing Kimberly in the second quarter actually pushing the ball a little quicker. They're getting better shots, but they're not holding the ball.
They've seemingly gotten a little bit of a flow of the basketball game now. They really just couldn't get anything going in the first quarter. Drake now looking back door offensive.
Oh, I don't know about that one.
Very questionable.
Yeah, here these guys go again. Second on Drake. I would agree with you on that one.
Well, I mean, to me, those kind of calls are blocking, unless they're saying, the referee said he used his elbow to clear him, but I didn't see it. If anything, you usually get the call. The offensive player will get called for the offensive foul when he drops his shoulder.
Oh,
but Drake did not do it on that play.
They're just going to say they're calling a wipe away. Backside. So now Fondulac with Dallas, Timmy Lloyd, and Drake Dieter all on the bench with those two fouls. Hermes with the ball. It's going to be close to a 5 second. He finally gets rid of it. Now reloaded out to Bravo. Hermes. Long two on the way. Well, that was a foot and a half short of the rim. Here comes Fondulac. Had Foster up front. Didn't see him. Now working to the near side. Pull up. Follow away shot from Jekyll. Won't go. Kept alive by Michaels. And steps in front is Ryan Hermes. Good job of anticipating there. Michaels falling out of bounds. Had again unloaded.
Oh, there you go. Yeah.
Three-pointer. One count. As a traveling violation, as both my officials to my left called that one at the same time.
How many turnovers is that for Kimberly?
That is their ninth turnover.
With 36 seconds to go here in the first half of play, Fondulac will undoubtedly work for the last shot, leading it 28-12. Travis Dieter will just yo-yo the dribble down to 22 seconds, 21-20. Over to Thomas. Look for the Cardinals to go with about 8 seconds on the clock. Right now it's 12. And they're going to take a 20-second timeout. Obviously, Dick Dieter's got something he just wants to work on. We'll keep it right here. And we'll take this time to remind you today's action brought to you by Call Insurance of Fondulac, who's joined forces with Jackson Agency to form one great agency under the same roof. That's Mitch Call, Bob Call, and Bob Jackson. Because they work for themselves, they work harder for you. Give them a call at 923-4020. And the next time you're home or business is in need of some painting or decorating, give Dave a call at Fond du Lac Decorating. For over 20 years, fine workmanship has always been a trademark of Fond du Lac Decorating. You always receive prompt, courteous service. Give him a call at 922-8051. And Mid-States Aluminum, serving the nation with creative solutions. That's Mid-States Aluminum, where progress through people makes the difference. Well, Mark, what are they going to do here?
I'd say they flatten it out for Trav.
Something here that's popping up in the air a little bit. Don't know exactly what that is. We'll get it straightened out. Travis with it. Take it down low. At the charity stripe, baseline. Fall away is going to be short. Followed by...
There you go.
Foster follows at the buzzer. And we've come to the end of one here from the Redbird Arena. At halftime, your Wisconsin EPS score. The Fond du Lac Cardinals, 30. And the Kimberly Papermakers, 12. And today's halftime, as always, brought to you by Baker String Cheese with only 79 calories. Each stick is the perfect snack food for the kids. The fun food that's so easy, just peel and eat. Healthy for you, high protein, 100% natural. That's Baker String Cheese, the official between your halftime snack food of our video sports team. And halftime also brought to you by KFC, featuring home delivery. Take the hassle out of mealtime with KFC. Halfway here at the Redbird Arena, Wisconsin EPS score, Fond du Lac 30 and Kimberly 12. We'll be right back with the second, or we'll look at the halftime stats right after this on your Cardinal Basketball Report.
Come expand with us. We're Wisconsin EPS, and we supply the Midwest leaders in the building, manufacturing, packaging, and roofing industries with the best in polystyrene products. Our ability to provide solutions to these many industries has made Wisconsin EPS the leader in polystyrene. We're expanding into the millennium. Come expand with us in a growing, ever-changing company, Wisconsin EPS.
But we're in a good spot, okay?
We got welcome back to the Redbird Arena. Just starting the second half here. We'll give you the numbers as we get going. Had a bit of a technical problem here we discovered in the first half we're going to take care of. So we're back at it. At any rate, just starting the second half. Once again, your Wisconsin EPS score is Fond du Lac 30 and Kimberly 12. Guys, it was all Fond du Lac here in the first half of play. And Kimberly did score 10 points in the second quarter, but still trails it by 18 here at the half.
Well, talking with Mark, discussing is what Kimberly's going to do different in this half, and really both Mark and I agree they got to get the ball inside. They got a lot of good looks from the outside, but for as big as they are, you think they got to work the ball inside a little more.
Offensive foul on Fond du Lac is going to go against Lloyd, and that's going to be his third. So Kimberly back with, we'll give you the stats and scoring in our first break in here. That may come right now as we've got a foul. How about taking a look at those first half statistics.
First half, the Cardinals shot 46% on 11 of 24, while compared for Kimberly, it was 30% on 6 of 20. Both teams finished the half with 12 rebounds apiece. Cardinals had 7 turnovers compared to 8 for Kimberly.
And that foul was on Travis Diener.
Travel.
Off the baseline, the turnaround, Jay, is good by Van Kuyk.
And official missed that call. Just like Mark said, it was a travel.
Yep.
Did you hear a whistle?
Didn't hear a whistle.
Then I guess he didn't miss the call. God, you guys are tough on officials. Ball banged out of bounds.
I don't know if I would have called. I would have called a foul there, too.
They'll call it.
They're not too consistent. That's the only thing you want from them is just be consistent.
Yeah, I would agree with you.
They're having a hard time doing that.
As a player, you have to adjust to their style, but you got to. You just want it to be consistent both ways and throughout the game.
Yep.
Well, I mean, it's amazing because the officials really can take a player out of his game, especially, as Mark said, if they're not calling it consistent.
Well, but it's up to the player. If they call it consistent, if they don't, yes. If they call it consistently, it's going to be up to the player to make the adjustments.
Right, most players can make that adjustment.
Ball out of bounds, last touch by Fond du Lac. And look at the scoring leaders here for the first half quickly. Fond du Lac was led by Drake Diener with 13, 9 points for Travis, and 4 for Timmy Lloyd. 2 points apiece for Jake Owen Foster. For Kimberly, they were led by Hermes with 4, and 2 points for Vandenberg, Swakowski, Rinke, and Royce with 2 also. That was their scoring for the first half, and that's 30-14. Three-pointer on the way. Back of the hoop, wouldn't have it for Kimberly. Hubble, long rebound back, grabbed by Graber. Loses the handle, but gets it right back as the Cardinals trying to save it from OB, and a three-pointer. Off the rim, no good. Nice follow, but an aggressive follow for Rinke, who took the three in an overback call. His second.
They're not even guarding Rinke on the perimeter. They're going to let them shoot that three all day.
I believe that's his first foul, actually. We'll check it officially, and it indeed is for his first foul. 6 minutes to go in the third quarter of play. Drake off to check that. That's Dallas. Now right back to Drake Diener between the rings. He'll work it to the near side. Now skip it down low to Traver. Check that, Dallas Diener. Too many Dieners on the court. Tipped by Foster. Check it, that wasn't Foster, it was Dallas again. Off to the near side, Van Kuyk with the basketball. He'll take the tray on the way, and rim in and out, wouldn't go. Pulled down by Travis Diener. Here come the Cardinals on the push. Travis is gonna leave it off now on the wing. Oh, it's gotta be a foul there as Jekyll is bumping, gotta call something one way or the other. And Thomas finishes it off from about 16.
Benny's always been able to hit that pull-up 15-foot jump shot.
32-14, Wisconsin EPS score. Nice hustle by Dallas Diener. Loses it out of bounds, but good hustle.
Good foresight by Dallas Diener seeing that pass coming. He overplayed it, just missed it. Actually ran into the out-of-bounds line, which prevented that turnover.
Yep.
Cardinal, or I should say the ball blocked by Travis Diener. Here come the Cardinals. Travis, leave it off. Thomas will finish it. Nice assist by Travis Diener. Thomas on the right side wing, filling the lanes.
There, Travis did a good job of holding the ball just long enough to commit the defensive men there.
Get it down low, fall away, won't go. Second time, no good by Van Kuyk, but he is fouled.
See, when they go inside, they get offensive rebounds and putbacks and get fouled. And I don't know why they don't go inside more.
Well, and the thing is, Dick Diener's not gonna change his defense until they can hit a perimeter shot. So they're gonna let him shoot from the outside as long as they're missing.
Yeah. Drake just picks up his third personal foul. So Fond du Lac now with a pair with 3 each. Drake and Lloyd each with 3 fouls. Drake will now come out. Foster in form. As Van Kuyk hits the first, one more to follow.
Al's got to step it up here along with Jesse Jekyll.
This is where we were talking about before with the quality minutes from the reserves.
Well, foul situations have forced Fond du Lac to bring in some reserves off the bench. Foster and Jesse Jekyll both are going to have to pay some bigger minutes today. Three-pointer by Dallas off the front of the rim. And here come the papermakers. Kimberly off the yo-yo dribble, Graber with it, and off to the left side, Rinke. Try to get it to the post down low, Vandenberg. Off the baseline, no. A foul off front, it's gonna go on Jekyll. Jesse will pick up number 1.
Well, slowly but surely, we are seeing Kimberly now getting the ball inside. You see Vandenberg do his one-on-one moves inside.
You guys must have been in that huddle at halftime for Kimberly. Thinking like a coach.
Well, you always got to change your mind. If you're not doing it from one way, you got to try something else.
Especially when you've had a pretty lackluster first half of play. Nice hustle by Kimberly. Who was that going out of bounds? It was Vervoort.
Another thing, Kimberly's not taking care of the ball. They got close to 12 turnovers.
Foster, check it with the basketball off to the right side sidewalk. Travis Diener on a penetration cut off, kick it back out. Thomas looks at the three, now thinks better of it. He'll take it to the near side, going left. Foster off the penetration, pulls up, cut off. Gonna reload it back out to Travis Diener. Travis on a yo-yo dribble. Gonna take the tray, on the way, and hit it.
Travis is such a good shooter off that dribble, and he's able to, with the crossover dribble, he's able to commit his defender to the opposite side.
Travis now with 12 in the basketball game for Fond du Lac.
I think Travis could do that just about every time. He just doesn't like taking bad shots at times, and he's a real unselfish player out there.
Long 2-1 away, pulled down by Dallas Dieter, has it stripped, stepping out of bounds was Ryan Hermes. He's going to say he was pushed, and frankly, I'd say I would agree with him. Dallas did give him a little elbow there on the baseline, but no call. That one will go for Fond du Lac, and the Cardinals will get it back. Jess Fight back into the game for Kimberly. Go back and look at that last one. You'll see a little push right there. Couldn't really tell if Matt Engel, because the camera angle kind of covered up, but Dallas used that arm and a foul. Down low on the other side.
Well, the audience is alive because they really came alive on that play.
Well, the foul will go against Vandenberg. No, yes it is, his third personal. Common foul, the Cardinals went about underneath their own basket to the left side. On a lob feed to Dallas Diener. Now swing it between the rings to the near side. Shot on away from Travis, won't go. Kimberly with the board. Here comes Hermes on the push. Loses the handle, should be a blocking foul, it will be.
I don't know if Ben Thomas is happy with that. You know, when the offensive player is out of control like that, I prefer it to be called an offensive foul. And that's, I think, was what Ben Thomas is explaining to the officials, he's out of control.
Thomas will pick up his second. Lob feed to Rinke. Skip it top of the circle, now to the near side to Ryan Hermes. Hermes off the penetration, and I could call a hand check on Fond du Lac. That was an iffy one.
Well, that's one thing I've been noticing this year in the high school basketball with the elimination of the hand checking to the pros. Now you've seen a lot of these officials are watching in high school. You get one little hand check and they're not afraid to call the foul.
Jesse, go ahead, Mark. Off the baseline, Jess Fight knocks it in.
I think the refs think we paid to watch them today.
Oh, they're giving us a show.
37-17, your Wisconsin EPS score, and Cardinals out in front by 20. Thomas off to the baseline. Get it down low. Good penetration, now kick back. Now reload it to Thomas, fakes the three. Get it off to Travis, back to Dallas Diener, down low on the baseline, Thomas. Lose the handle, now regains. Skip pass across the way, knocked out of bounds. Last touch by Fight, and we'll go back to Fond du Lac. 1:57 left in the third quarter of play.
You know, there you saw a good play of not panicking on this Cardinal offense. They dribble into trouble and they just keep the ball and look for the open man.
Again, we're talking about experience. These guys have played so much basketball and gone through the years. Travis, yeah. Got that one right?
Yes.
This team they got this year has been playing together since about third or fourth grade.
That's traveling violation on Rinke on the right side. Yeah, they've pretty much experienced it all.
Yep.
And the thing they'd like to experience more than anything right now would be a state tournament berth. Of course, a long ways before that gets to the point, but that's on their minds.
Yep.
Traveling violation on Jekyll.
You see a lot of players that to get set up, they usually like to take that dribble to get their feet square. That time he forgot to put the ball down.
Little jump step. One 1:15 to go in the third quarter of play. For Fort, skips it to the near side. Hermes, ball above his head. Coming back now right, gonna go to the glass, laid off a little bit hard. Look out, wow.
Foul is going to go on Kimberly. Boy, hitting the, is that Rinky? Hit the floor hard.
And they're going to call the foul on him as well, which given it wasn't over the back.
And it adds insult to injury as Rinky picks up his second. Well, he popped right back up. That just looked like it hurt.
Sounded worse than it was, actually was.
Inside of a minute to go in the third quarter of play. Off to Foster. See if Fond du Lac is going to go, if they're going to try to hold it for one. They've had a tendency, as of recent time, to run that clock a long ways on at the end of a quarter. I think they're going to do it again with 34 seconds to go.
And there's really not many offenses in this conference that can hold onto a ball for that time of span.
That's true.
So many good ball handlers and players that can handle the ball for Fond du Lac. But it usually ends up in Travis's hand someplace along the line.
Trav will get a shot off here.
But before that, a reach-in foul and Tim Vervoort. It's his second. Common foul. And Dick Diener's going to get Drake back in here for a little bit more offense with 15 seconds to go in the quarter. Remember, he's playing with three fouls. Lob feed in to Travis Diener. Back down to 10. A couple more seconds, then Travis will get it going. Now he's doubled up. Got to get off to Drake. Now the baseline. Foster with an open three. Wolf draw nothing but air, and we've come to the end of the third quarter of play here from the Redbird Arena. After three complete, Wisconsin EPS score, Fond du Lac 39 and Kimberly 17. We'll be back with the final 8 minutes right after this on your Cardinal Basketball Report.
Kathy Parrish of Fond du Lac.
Holiday has an extremely good reputation. Being a teacher, I'm very, very busy. So, their service has just been phenomenal. They're just there to please the customer, and that to me means a lot. I've just been extremely impressed with Holiday Automotive, a great place to buy cars. I like Holiday a lot.
Holiday, you'll pay less at Holiday.
Back at the Redbird Arena, 8 minutes left. Red Crows, the third quarter stats.
Both teams got 10 shots off. The Cardinals were 4 of 10 for 40%, and the Paper Makers just 2 of 10 for 20%. Both teams are even on the boards with 6 rebounds apiece, and both teams also had 3 turnovers.
So Kimberly in a game, if you look at numbers real quickly, probably shooting about 25% at the best overall, but a little bit less than that. Banker won't go for Kimberly. Fond du Lac just continues to put staggering defensive numbers on the board all year long.
You know, in its terms, you know, it's great defense by Fondy, but I mean, the shots that Kimberly is getting, they really should be able to finish.
Drake Diener will hit the jumper with 7:35 to go in the fourth quarter of play. Lob feed to Rinky, and this should go and will. That's a good call. It's going to go on Drake, but you've got to allow the player room to come down.
You got to give him a foot, a foot to be able to come down. Drake there was a little too close.
So Drake will pick up his fourth. And fortunately, this is a game where it's probably not a factor with he being in foul trouble. Cardinals are over the limit.
You can always tell how intense this game is for Dick Diener. He still has his sports jacket on. So the concern there with the fourth foul for Drake, I don't think is.
Last week, I think he had it off about a minute and a half into the game.
Oshkosh West game, it didn't even take him that long.
Rinky hits a pair. Oh, Kimberly now 3 for 4 in the second half from the charity strike after going 0 for 3 in the first half.
Kimberly's coming out a little 1-3-1.
Trying to trap.
Trap zone.
Yep. Trying to trap as they cross the timeline. Skip pass, that's a good place for the skip. Right down low now to Dallas, reload it. Touch pass down low. Cardinals a great ball rotation once again. And timeout's gonna be taken by Fond du Lac. 6:54 left. Timeout in the court. Fond du Lac leads it 41-19.
For repairs, upgrades, sales, and maintenance of your computer, call Dan and Bob at EMB Computer Services at 923-6030. We make house calls. That's EMB Computer Services, Fond du Lac.
The next time your home or business is in need of some painting or decorating, give Dave a call at Fond du Lac Decorating. For over 20 years, fine workmanship has always been a trademark of Fond du Lac Decorating. You'll always receive prompt, courteous service. Call 922-8051.
As we inbound the basketball following the quick timeout, Cardinals with it once again. Travis Diener with the basketball, deciding to set the offense. They stay in the 1-3-1 trapping zone. Skip pass over the top to Thomas. Get to the post, now back out to Thomas, right back. Working to the near side, bounce pass over to Travis Diener. Kimberly very aggressive in the 1-3-1, but Fond du Lac keeping good ball rotation. And kicked into the backcourt. Ball will go back to the Cardinals.
With this type of defense, this shows you with offense what ball fakes can do for you. It seems that the Kimberly Papermakers are not staying home on that first ball fake, so that's why the Cardinals are getting easy passes.
6:20 left in this contest. Fond du Lac with the basketball. And a foul on Rinke down in the right side coffin corner. His third.
The 15th foul for Kimberly.
So Cardinals on the inbound. Travis over. Now over to Thomas. Ball tipped into the backcourt. Unless got much more patient, ball kicked out of bounds again. Keep in mind, once again, later on this evening, stay tuned. About 10 o'clock, we'll have gals back in basketball for you as the number 3 ranked Lady Cardinals will be taking on the Nina Rockets. 8 o'clock tip-off right here at the Redbird Arena. We'll have it for you again at 10 o'clock this evening. Tuesday, by the way, we'll have Fond du Lac Cardinal Hockey against the Sun Prairie Cardinals. Non-conference action for both teams, but that's always a great matchup between the two. Off the baseline, a tray for Drake Diener.
Great patience.
Yeah, I don't know why he doesn't shoot more threes than what he does. He's pretty much automatic on them threes. He should be shooting a lot more.
You taught him well, Mark. I know you were his tutor last year. 5.5 to go in this contest. Fond du Lac walking away with one here early this afternoon, 44-19, got off and running in the first quarter, exactly what John Myron did not want to have for Kimberly. Cardinals got up and led it 13-2 at the end of one quarter of play, and it's gone downhill from there if you're a Papermaker fan. Three-pointer on the way, back of the hoop. Pulled down by Diener. Here comes Drake, wings to the both sides. Reverse layup and a foul. Well, Lloyd trying to reverse it, but he is fouled as he goes underneath the hoop. Could be either of two players, and it's going to go against Swakowski, his first.
You know, the Cardinal defense played very well. Last time they played Kimberly, held them to 26 points with 4:52 to go in this fourth quarter. Kimberly just has 19 points.
Another look at here. Yeah, if Fond du Lac played Kimberly all year long, they would have pretty ugly numbers. Timmy Lloyd gets the first, one more to follow. Today's action brought to you by Mon Pa's Sitco Express. And the pumps are always open at Mon Pa's Sitco on the corner of 12th and Main. They pump the gas for you Monday, Wednesday, and Friday between 9 and 2. It's Mon Pa's Sitco Express in Fond du Lac. Lloyd with a pair. He's got 6 overall in the basketball game. Inside of 5 left in this contest now. Off to the near side, Swakowski, I should say. Out with the ball stripped. Get it off to Graber. His shot off the back of the hoop and caught up above. Well, that doesn't happen just every day. Now somebody's got to jump up there and get it. Now they'll bring another ball. And here's where an official could look really stupid if he can't hit this thing. Hey, and give him two. Or he can look really good.
Yeah. And the official didn't even crack a smile.
No, he didn't. He's not having any fun at all, is he?
Yeah, I think that's our play of the game.
Yeah, there you go.
Like I said, we paid to watch the refs.
Yeah, Mark, I think you're right. .430 exactly left in this one. Fondalac will walk the ball across the timeline. Travis Diener with it. Now he'll leave it to Ben Thomas. Cardinals are getting, or staying very patient. They've gone back to the man-to-man defense. And a foul away from the basketball on Kimberly. It's going to go on Hermes, his second.
In games like these where you got almost a 30-point lead, it's good to see, you know, the starters in there and keep in their game plan. You tend to see them going a little more out of control and trying to get quicker shots, but this you know, Dick Diener's a great coach, and he knows how to keep his team in line.
Yeah, if you're caught loafing out there, even if you got a 30-point lead, he's going to find someplace on the bench for you.
That never happened to you, did it, Mark?
Maybe a couple times.
But as a player, when you've got this 30-point lead or whatever, and you experienced that a lot, you had some good teams you were on, but you're getting into the fourth quarter, 4 minutes left, you know, it's got to be easy to start, you know, getting a little bit lackadaisical, a little bit less hustle.
Well, what really helps is in practice, you know, every practice we go to, we still have that high intensity. You know, every game we play in, we try to, you know, maintain a high intensity. So you don't really have time to loaf out there because he'll find someone else that wants to play in front of you.
And that's the main thing is, you know, if you can't do it, Dick won't have any problem replacing right. You no matter who you are.
Yep. But doesn't Van Kuyk, by the way, with his second personal foul, but when you've got that 30-point lead with 4 minutes to go, it's emotionally difficult to keep that intensity.
Yeah, well, the teams that I've played on, we found satisfaction just beating teams by as many points as we can. You know, just try to blow them right out of the gym.
Michael's in for Thomas.
A lot of times at Fondalac, you know, you get a, you know, 10, 15 point win, and, you know, people say, you know, what the heck happened? Yeah. Fondalac, you know, didn't play so well, you know. And
that's called being spoiled.
Yeah, yeah. You go in the locker room, and, you know, it seems like a loss in there when you win by 15 points. But
I think Fondalac has become somewhat spoiled over the years.
Yeah.
19 points right now is what Fondalac has held this to, and that's equaling their defensive school record they set earlier this season.
No, that was 16 points.
That was 16?
Yeah,
okay.
That was 16.
Oh, that's right. You're correct, Mark. And turnaround no good. Last touch by Fondalac. 16. That's amazing. I mean, we saw it, and it's still amazing.
And the one thing amazing about that is the reserves were in early, and they held the team to, you know, little points too, and there you saw the happiness on everybody's face when they were able to hold the team to 16 points.
That was against the Lightning of Appleton North, who have struggled all year long, but nonetheless, I mean, I think you could bring some grade school teams in here that would have a chance of scoring 16 points. Clock rolling, 3:20. Travis, yo-yo dribble to the right side. Now he's going to reverse it, bring it back out, kick it out to Lloyd. Off to the left side, Drake Diener. Drake off the penetration, doubled, stripped of the basketball. Now still loose on the court. Still loose. Lloyd comes away with it. He'll take it off the glass and kick it in. Lloyd with 8 points in the basketball game. Fondalac now leads it 52-19. And a foul on Michaels, and he's like, well, what did I do? His first.
Well, now he'll get his name in the stat sheet, so.
There you go. Today's game brought to you by Jet Street Car Wash of Fondalac. Fondalac's original car wash since 1962 with two great locations to serve you on Scott Street and Pioneer Lane. Jet Street Car Wash. Fondalac's gonna go to the Pines now. Bring in Ryan Lloyd, along with Ben Wisniewski. Also in for Fondalac, Joel Dilling. Jesse Jacob back, and rounding him out, of course, is Joe Michaels.
Yeah, let's see if the reserves can outscore him here.
First free throw is good by Hermes. We'll get one more. Kimberly without a field goal here in the second, or check that, fourth quarter.
Well, three from the field.
Yep, three, 4 for 4 from the charity stripe, but no field goals. Matter of fact, only 2 field goals in the second half of play for Kimberly. So this is now what we, in the old days, referred to as garbage time. I think that was saying was made famous by the old Eddie Doucette from the Bucks years and years ago, dealing with the rebound. Leave it off to Lloyd, the backcourt. He'll bring it across the timeline. In some trouble, got to get rid of it. Finally does. Jekyll pops out to help him out. 2:20 left.
Now Jekyll's going to have to step up here, and he's going to have to be the veteran on this court.
Yes, he would be the one with the most playing time by far and away. Splitting the defense. Lloyd to the racket. Good. Lloyd with his first two of the basketball game. 2 minutes left. Hermes kick it back out. Three-pointer on the way by Fight, and he'll hit it. I believe that's their first, yes it is, their first three of the basketball game. Fond du Lac with, I believe, 1, 2, 3 overall. And a blocking foul will go against Ryan Lloyd. His first personal. He'll be over the limit, so we'll be shooting bonus free throws the rest of the way. And Hermes back to the line. Just got done hitting 2 for 2. Ben DeCook into the basketball game for Kimberly, his first appearance. Hermes hits the first, one more to follow. Mike's Music is your instrument rental center in the Fond du Lac area. Call us at 923-1925.